Hello friends, today we are going to do the chapter Tom Has a Toothache. Monday morning found Tom Sawyer miserable. Monday morning was always found him so, because it began another week's slow suffering in school. He generally began that day with wishing he had no intervening holiday. It made the going into captivity and fetters again so much more odious. Tom lay thinking. Presently, it occurred to him that he wished he was sick. Then he could stay home from school. Here was a vague possibility. He canvassed his system. No ailment was found, and he investigated again. This time he thought he could detect colicky symptoms, and he began to encourage them with considerable hope. But they soon grew feeble and presently died wholly away. He reflected further. Suddenly, he discovered something. One of his upper front teeth was loose. This was lucky. He was about to begin and grow as a starter, as he called out when it occurred to him that if he came into court with that argument, his aunt would pull it out and that would hurt. So he thought he would hold the tooth in reserve for the present and seek further. Nothing offered for some little time. And then he remembered hearing the doctor tell about a certain thing that laid a patient for 2 or 3 weeks and threatened to make him lose a finger. So that boy eagerly drew his sword toy from under the sheet and held it up for inspection. But now he did not know the necessary symptoms. However, it seemed well worthwhile to chance it. So he fell to groaning with considerable spirit. But Sid slept on unconscious. Tom groaned louder and fancied that he began to feel pain in the toe. No result from Sid. Tom was panting with his exertions by this time. He took a rest and then swelled himself up and fetched a succession of admirable groans. Sid snored on. Tom was aggravated. He said, "Sid, Sid," and shook him. This course worked well, and Tom began to groan again. Sid yawned, stretched, then brought himself up on his elbow with a snort and began to stare at Tom. Tom went on groaning. Sid said, "Tom, say, Tom." There was no response from Tom. "Here, Tom, Tom, what is the matter, Tom?" And he shook him and looked in his face anxiously. Tom moaned out, "Oh, don't, Sid, don't juggle me. Why, what's the matter, Tom? I must call Auntie." "No, never mind. It will be over soon, maybe. Don't call anybody. But I must. Don't groan so, Tom. It's awful. How long you have been this way?" "Hours. Ouch. Oh, don't stare so, Sid. You will kill me." "Tom, why did you wake me sooner? Oh, Tom, don't. It makes me frightened to hear you. Tom, what is the matter?" "I forgive you for everything, Sid. Everything you have ever done to me. When I am gone. Oh, Tom, you aren't dying, are you? I forgive everybody, Sid. Till am so, Sid, and Sid, you give me my window sash and my cat with one eye to that new girl that's come to town and tell her. But Sid had snatched his clothes and gone. Tom was suffering in reality now. So handsomely was his imagination working, and so his groans had gathered quite a Guinean tone. Sid flew downstairs and said, "Oh, Aunt Polly, come. Tom's dying." "Dying? Yes, ma'am." "Don't wait. Come quick." "Rubbish. I don't believe it." But she fled upstairs. Nevertheless, with Sid at her heels, and her face grew white too, and her lips trembled. When she reached the bedside, she gasped, "You, Tom, Tom, what's the matter with you?" "Oh, Auntie, I am." "What's the matter with you? What is the matter with you, child?" "Oh, Auntie, my sore toes." Mortified, the old lady sank down into a chair and laughed a little, then cried a little, then did both together. This restored her and she said, "Tom, what a turn you did give me. Now you shut up that nonsense and climb out of this." The groans ceased and the pain vanished from the toe. The boy felt a little foolish and he said, "Aunt Polly, it seemed mortified and it hurt so. I never minded my tooth at all." "Your tooth? Indeed. What's the matter with your tooth?" "One of them's loose and it ages perfectly awful." "Dear, dear, now don't begin that groaning again. Open your mouth." "Well, your tooth is loose, but you are not going to die with that." Saying that, Auntie was about to get a silk thread and a chunk of fire out of the kitchen when Tom cried out, "Oh, please, Auntie, don't pull it out. It doesn't hurt anymore. I wish I may never stir if it does." "Please don't, Auntie. I don't want to stay home from school." "Oh, you don't. Don't you? So, all this row was because you thought you had get to stay home from school and go finishing." "Tom, Tom, I love you so. And you seem to try every way you can to break my old heart with your outrageousness. Now that tooth will come out on its own. Go to sleep now and we will decide what to do when you wake up." An extract from The Adventures of Tom Sawyer by Mark Twain. Thank you, friends. Bye-bye.